Today, let us discuss about the three cases of elements subjected to uniaxial stress, biaxial stress, and biaxial stress with shear. Okay. So now let us come to the first case. Here, the element subjected to uniaxial stress. Here is the element subjected to uniaxial stress. It is stress along only one axis. You can observe here, only along the x-axis, the member is subjected to stress. So this is the case of element. This is the element or a member subjected to stress along only one axis. Okay. Now, for this member, if we need to find the normal stress and tangential stress on this inclined plane, if we take any inclined plane on this member, how to find the normal stress and tangential stress? Normal stress means to this element, if you want to find the normal stress, it will be perpendicular. Perpendicular to the inclined plane. This is known as normal stress because it is perpendicular to this plane. And if you want to find the tangential stress on this plane, tangential means it will be parallel to the plane. So this is the tau theta. How to find these two values means, here is the equation. Normal stress on inclined plane sigma theta is equal to sigma x into cos square theta. What is sigma theta? It is the normal stress on this plane. And what is sigma x? It is the stress which is acting on the member along the x-axis. And what is the theta? Theta is nothing but inclination of this plane to the vertical line. This angle is known as theta. If you know the value of sigma x and theta, you can find the value of sigma theta. Just substitute sigma x and theta and find the value of sigma theta. Similarly, if you want to find tangential stress on the inclined plane, tangential stress on this plane, so this is the tau theta. This is nothing but the tau theta, which is the tangential stress on the inclined plane. Tau theta is equal to sigma x by 2 into sin 2 theta. Sigma x by 2 into sin 2 theta. What is sigma x? As I told you, this is the stress value. Substitute the value of sigma x, and here is the theta, this inclination. Substitute these two values and you can find the value of tau theta. These equations are already available. Sigma theta is equal to sigma x cos square theta and tau theta is equal to sigma x by 2 sin 2 theta. These are already available in your data handbook. So equation number is, this is 2.10. In your data handbook, it is second chapter and 10th equation. And in this equation comes to be in second chapter in 11th equation. 2.11 means it is the second chapter and equation number is 11. Already available. These equations are available in your data handbook. Next, let us come to the biaxial stress case. Here, the stress is active along x-axis and also along y-axis. That is, along both x and y-axis, the stress is acting. So, it is known as biaxial stress condition. Biaxial stress condition. So, if you want to find the normal stress and inclined stress, normal stress and shear stress on this inclined plane, how to find? Again, equations are available. This is the equation, sigma theta is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos 2 theta. And its equation number is 2.26. Equation number is 2.26 in your data handbook. So, you can find the normal stress on the inclined plane. On this inclined plane, what is the value of normal stress? That is sigma theta, can be found using this equation. Similarly, if you want to find the tangential stress on this plane, inclined plane, tangential stress on inclined plane, tau theta is equal to minus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sin 2 theta. Its equation number is 2.27 in your data handbook. So, using these two equations, we can find the value of normal stress and also tangential stress on this plane if it is subjected to both stress along x-axis, that is sigma x, and stress along y-axis, that is sigma y. Now let us come to the third case, that is element subjected to biaxial stress along with the shear. Here, along with the biaxial stress, this is the sigma x, stress along x-axis, sigma y, stress along y-axis. Along with that, there is also one more stress, that is the shear stress. Shear stress is tau xy. Okay, so you know what is shear stress? The stress acting parallel to the surface is known as shear stress. So here the stress is acting along x-axis, also along y-axis. Along with that, there is a shear stress induced on the member. Okay. So in this situation, how to find out the normal stress and tangential stress on this inclined plane? Let us understand. So again, the equations are readily available in your data handbook. It is 2.30 and 2.31 in your data handbook. That is, you can find the normal stress sigma theta is equal to sigma x plus y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos 2 theta plus tau x by sin 2 theta. That is, you will be knowing the value of sigma x, which is given in the problem, and sigma y will also be given, and you also know the value of theta, what is the inclination. Just substitute and find the value of sigma theta. Similarly, you can find the shear stress on the inclined plane. Tau theta is equal to minus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 sin 2 theta plus tau xy into cos 2 theta. Substitute all the values and find the shear stress on this member. So shear stress is the tau theta and normal stress is the sigma theta. Normal means it will be acting perpendicular to the plane. Shear stress means it will be acting parallel to the plane. You can find these two values using these two equations in your data.